Well, the U.S. is not the only country seeking energy independence. Israel began pumping its first offshore natural gas over the weekend from the Tamar Basin in eastern Mediterranean. I spoke with Israeli oil and gas analyst Richard Gusso of DS Securities on how the new flow of natural gas will affect the Israeli economy.
Right. Well, the Tamar gas project was discovered several years ago, and over the weekend we had the first flow of gas after a heavy investment and much effort put into it by the partners. The effect on the Israeli economy will be several-fold. You have the corporations will be saving money. They'll become more efficient by reducing energy costs. The growth, the GDP growth in Israel will rise by about 1% in 2013. Without the gas, it would have been about 2.8%. With the gas, it adds about another 1% to 3.8%. It'll also result in lower inflation, stronger currency, which can also be a double-edged sword because that could result in Dutch disease, so the Bank of Israel will have to be very cautious about that. But overall, very, very positive news for the Israeli economy. Almost everything that will be positive will be a positive result from the flow of gas, but again, a little bit of caution from the Bank of Israel on the side of the currency.
Richard, here in this country, we talk about fracking as a game changer. Is this a game changer in any way for Israel?
Absolutely. Israel in the past has been reliant on external sources mostly for its energy sources. Now it could become almost self-sufficient in many ways. And in fact, with the discovery of the Leviathan prospect, we believe that in a few years it will become an exporter of gas. That a lot will depend on the government and the allowances they'll make for export. But that truly will become the second game changer after Tamar.
And who would likely be the recipients of that net gas exported outside of Israel?
Asia is a target market, considering the high prices there that are currently in the market, although we don't know what the prices will be like in several years. And Europe as well. Europe would like to decrease its reliance on Gazprom and would like to perhaps use other sources of gas. So Europe is also a target market for the exports.
Richard, there are really two stories here as I hear you explain what's happening. Number one, it's energy self-sufficiency for Israel, and number two, it's the ability to export, where all of a sudden now Israel becomes more of a player in the local economy. How does that combination change the balance of power within the region?
Well, it's still relatively small compared to the region, but you know, we used to joke here that Moses took a wrong turn when he came to Israel, but apparently not. Apparently, maybe he knew what he was doing. The exports of gas will compete with some of the exports, perhaps from Qatar, but still, it will be a relatively small player. But from Israel's viewpoint, it's a major discovery, both Tamar and Leviathan, and will have major impact on the local economy.
And finally, in the last 20-30 seconds, Noble Energy, based here in the U.S., is involved. Are there some other local companies that our viewers should be aware of?
Sure. You have the Delek companies. That would be Delek Drilling and Avner, both of which have stakes in both Tamar and Leviathan. You have Izramco, which has a major stake in Tamar. And you have Ratio, which has a major stake in Leviathan prospect. And also, you should be aware that Woodside, the Australian E&P company, has signed a deal to acquire 30% of Leviathan. But again, that will be dependent on the approval of the export committee recommendations.
That was DS Securities senior analyst Richard Gusso from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange. And isn't it amazing, Steph? You know, we talk so much about energy independence here in the U.S., and that's made possible by net gas. And guess what? It's happening in Israel. It's the same story, right? It's fascinating.
But it's extraordinary because 10 years ago, would you ever have even ventured the thought when you think about energy independence and think about how dependent we were on the Middle East?
No, and I mean, this has only happened in the past 2 to 3 years. And of course, you know, credit Aubrey McClendon, really, of Chesapeake. He was the one who said fracking is a game changer. Ironic, he is no longer running the company that he helped found, the second largest nat gas driller. But that's the whole story.
McClendon is a game changer.
McClendon's a game changer. Nat gas is a game changer. We see it in the U.S., and now we're seeing it in Israel.